Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Yo. Mic check. 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 Mic check.
Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check.
Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic
check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check.
Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. Mic check. M
a lot of people don't understand that they're in jail. More in jail or imprisonment than you are free. You don't have a freedom of thought, feelings, and emotions. Because you're not free if you're being influenced or your emotions are being dictated by people outside of you. This is why the elder said the eye is the light to the soul, because it can conflict with you, what you allow to get in your eye, your ear, even how you speak. Are you really, truly free this morning with what people say? And here's how you know you're truly free: when somebody can say something negative to you, but it has no power or effect, nor does it change you in a negative way. Why? Because you're free. Some of us don't got to be in jail physically, because you're already in prison mentally. You got shackles on your mind. And that's why you can't grow. And it shows. It shows, because you're not, even how you operate, is conflicted. How you move, your day-to-day decisions. Are you really, truly free? Because when you're free, you have the options to move, to lead yourself to greater possibilities. See, I can't live for other people without me living for myself first. See, it's okay to live for other people, but you got to live for you first. Y'all got to learn how to be free. You care too much. Too much cares are going out, but not enough cares are developing and being stored from within. You always worried about what somebody else going to think about you. God said, when you going to think about yourself? You the one got to carry you all the way all through the day. For these next 24 hours, you with you. Every day, you with you. You going to die with you. So your main concern should be how you feel. Because before you even consider somebody's opinion outside of you about you, you better make sure you're secure about how you feel about you. Folk are great at manipulating weak-minded people. It's the power of influence. When somebody can come into your day and change the way you feel or prepared about your day in a negative way. You can't be serious or focus about you for 5 minutes without thinking about somebody else. This is irresponsible. And you wonder why you can't get to where you want to be. You wonder why there isn't high levels of consistency in doing great things. It's the consistency for me. You got to learn how to keep showing up in greatness, showing up in joy, showing up in peace, showing up with great focus if you're trying to receive what you truly desire out of this life. You got to want this as bad as you want to breathe. As bad as you truly want to breathe, you got to want this. And the reality is, in your wanting, can't nobody alive that supports you, love you, can want more for you than you want for yourself. See, here's the issue about your goals. If you got people around you that supports you, love you, and their want for you is more than you, you'll never get to what you desire. Hello. Wisdom says nobody can want more for you than you want for yourself. So I always make sure I'm numero uno. I always make sure that I want what I want for me more than anybody else want for me, because you will never get there. You got people around you that love you and want to see you win, but they overworking themselves. Because you don't want it as bad as they want to see you make it in life. So make sure when it comes to what you desire, your goals, your dreams, your aspirations, you're bona fide about it. You eat and sleep this. Your heart panteth after this. Your desire is so high that you are so good. You so focused on this thing that it makes people want to push you there. Support you there, love you there, help you get there. Everybody that say I love you don't love you, baby. Let me tell you that right now. For love is an action word. Love is an action word. So before you even consider saying I love you, it should be proven or shown consistently, effortlessly. This ain't no routine or no rehearsal. When somebody loves, they just love because love is. Oh, why'd you do that? Because I love you. Oh, man, you had to do that, but I did it because I love you. Oh, man, I didn't know you was going to do that because I love you. Love always shows up because love is. Love can come without no explanation. See, when you got to think about stuff, you got a routine, you got to rehearse. It ain't real. It ain't real. This ain't no life, ain't no rehearsal. Once you die, you don't get a do-over. So the reality is with us, we got to start taking our life serious. Bet on yourself in a way that it inspires somebody else to want to get their life together. All I see with your life right now is nothing but space and opportunity. That's all I see. Space and opportunity. Rooms for improvement. Oh, I'm bettering myself in that area. I'm going to strengthen myself in that area. I'm going to increase in that area. All I see is space and opportunity. See, you got to want more out of your life. Because somewhere or another, you've trained yourself to settle, accept, and allow any old thing. That ain't right. That's disrespectful to ask the reason why you were created. The reason why you're still here. And you can become a liability and a disservice to the very people that depend on you. Your mate, your friends, your family, your children. Come on now. You see how it just don't affect you, but it also affects the people that you tied to. And some of y'all fail to realize folk look up to you. But if you give up, you teaching them how to give up. If you quit, you teach them how to quit. If you move in weakness, you teach them how to be weak. I had to tell a queen the other day about be careful what you're projecting and what you allow to happen to you in front of your children. Because you build a perspective. And from their immature mind frame, if you don't teach them or give them clarity, they're going to think that's a way of life. And it could be something negative. Children don't learn by what you say. Children learn by what you do. Because they're still learning. They're still developing. The brain does not naturally fully form at a whole state of development until you reach the age of 25. So you think for one second that I ain't concerned about what gets in my children's eyes, what gets in my children's ears, what gets in my children's heart, what gets in my children's soul? No. The scripture says charity starts at home. What does that mean? That means teachings shouldn't start outhouse. Teachings should start in-house. So when my children step out into the world, they're qualified at the age that they are, if not more. Because the reality is, I challenge and I teach them. I also prepare them for what's out there. No, if y'all want to learn something, I tell them all the time when we have our weekly meetings. If y'all want to learn something, come here. Come right here. I'm going to give it to you raw. I'm going to give it to you real. I'm going to shoot it to you straight. See, if you allow your children to get teachings out house, they can get false teachings and be led astray or led the wrong way. So this is why the scripture says charity starts at home. They should be getting it in-house, not out-house, because them streets don't love you. And 9 times out of 10, everybody out-house ain't in your best interest. So when charity starts at home, love should start at home. Help should start at home.
Work should start at home. Discipline should start at home. Financial stability should start at home. Education starts at home. Charity starts at home. So why are y'all allowing your children to get these teachings outhouse first when they should be getting it in-house? Charity starts at home. Self-respect, self-esteem. Talking about the many different difficulties that people face from a day on a day-to-day basis in the world. Any question you got, come get it here. Any concern you got, come get it here. Charity starts at home, baby. I tell my children this all the time. It starts right here. Right here, right now. Right here. But what I want from you, I want you to challenge yourself to grow. Yeah, yeah. I want you to challenge yourself to grow. Challenge you to grow. Because for what you're trying to do, who you're trying to be, what you're trying to have, there's going to have to be a level of maturity in you for where God is taking you. Come on, speak, God. Speak. For what you're trying to do, for what you're trying to desire, you're going to need more maturity up here in your temple. You're going to need to mature more. See, you can't allow your desires to be high, but your productivity and development to be very low and very poor. No, no. Challenge yourself to grow. I was talking to a neighbor yesterday, and I said to him, I said, hey, brother, like, there's always room for improvement. But you got to set new challenges to grow. Because if you're trying to do this, that, and the third, you can't come with the same you. See, y'all be trying to go to new things with the old you, but wonder why you can't be stable. Wonder why you can't be truly successful. Wonder why you can't be fulfilled. Because you tried to receive something new with the old you. This is why I'm challenging you to grow. I need you to grow up. I need you to mature. I need you to be conscious of how you respond to certain difficulties, certain challenges, certain negative things you hear. If you always getting mad when somebody says something you don't like, it ain't just them that's the problem, it's you. God said you are so consistent in your negative response. When you gonna grow up? I'll wait. I got my watch on today, but I don't need my watch to know what time it is. I'll wait. When are you going to grow up? We already have came to the conclusion that that person ain't no good. We already came to the conclusion that that person don't like you. We already came to the conclusion that that person is just going to be who they are. But God says, what makes you any different from them if you react the same way? You always get mad when you hear something you don't like. Here come your immaturity. Here come your immaturity, because you don't want to grow up just as much as they don't. Some people be getting cloned because you choose wrong when they did you wrong. You stoop down to their level. God said at some point, for the sake of your future, for the sake of your success, for the sake of your development, for the sake of your legacy, for the sake of your children that look up to you, when are you going to grow up? When are you going to mature? When are you going to accept the challenge for change so you can grow for not just what you want out of this life, but where God planned to take you in your life? See, these upper levels come with great requirements. Come on, speak, God. My mother been telling me and my brothers this all day, all our life. She said, much is given, baby. Much is required. My mother used to walk around the kitchen when she get blessed or when something don't work out in her favor. And she said, babies, listen, much is given, much is required. She said, you think that next level you seeking don't come with heavy requirements, baby? You gonna have to open up your mind and ask God for more wisdom, more knowledge, more understanding, baby. Because she said, much is given, much is required. See, y'all want to go to the next level without no change. Come on. It ain't going to work for you. You ain't going to be able to stay. You ain't going to be able to maintain where you're going if you won't change to grow. See, you trying to go to something new with the old you. And God said, that ain't going to work. It ain't going to work for you. It ain't going to work because as quick as you get there, you're going to want to leave. Why? Because you ain't qualified. You wasn't ready. You got there prematurely. Yeah. You wasn't fully developed. You didn't take you serious. So your success don't take you serious. Either life don't take you serious. God don't take you serious. The people that's trying to help you don't take you serious no more either. You got to challenge yourself to change. Because for where you trying to go, where God is taking you, it's going to require something new out of you. Yeah. You can't approach something new with the old you. You're going to have to develop more. I challenge you to grow. I challenge you to grow up this morning. I challenge you to change your response. I challenge you to stop making excuses. I challenge you to make new friends and build new bridges. I challenge you to tap more into your maturity and be conscious of how you respond when negative things occur, when negative things happen. I challenge you. See, your desires cannot be high, but your work below. You can't want a lot of things out of life, but not be willing to put in the work, not be willing to change, not be willing to develop, not be willing to take constructive criticism about certain behaviors you created, certain people you allowed to come in your life that are no good, certain things you entertained, but it ain't helping you. At some point, when you grow up and mature, you move accordingly. You give passes. I had somebody say something crazy to me. I said, you on that today? Man, have a great day. And I left it at that. I said to myself, baby, the way my joy set up, come on, speak, God. Well, the way my joy set up, I ain't got time to be focusing on what you just said. Have a great day. Have a great day. Get on. You're talking wrong. You ain't speaking on my energy. You ain't on my frequency. You ain't on my level. Oh, you don't even know how I even prepared my morning. So the way you talking, you go left and I go right. Yeah, that's what I told him. The way my joy set up, I can't even entertain that. Man, I'm so blessed. I'm so secure with who I am. What I stand for. I got plans. I got goals. I got dreams. I got aspirations. The way my joy is set up, baby, I can't even entertain what you just said. Keep it moving. Go on now. Get thee behind me, say it. See, y'all got to learn how to shut stuff down. Shut people down. Shut their words down. It didn't even touch me. I was like, that was cute. Bye. Ain't nobody entertaining you. Ain't nobody entertaining you. The way my joy set up, the way my success is rolling and flowing and going and growing, I can't even entertain that. See, y'all make time for the wrong situations. This is why you can't be successful. You make time for negativity. You give them a piece of your mind. No, baby, I ain't give you a piece of my mind because I got peace in my mind. Hello. I would give you a piece of my mind, but I got peace in my mind. And the way my joy is set up, I can't even entertain you. I can't even focus on what you just said negatively. Folk come at you just to try to get you off track. Folk want to come in your day just to get you discouraged. Folk being used by the devil because the devil know you about to get a breakthrough. You about to get a blessing. You about to go to the next level. But are you qualified? Are you ready? Are you serious about what you want out of this life? That is the question. The reality is, you got to start betting on you. You got to start protecting your eyes, protecting your ears, protecting your spirit. Because to get to where you want to be in life, You're going to have to make some great sacrifices. My mama would parade around the kitchen because she would cook and cook for her boys. I'm going to tell you something, that woman would cook because she know we ate. She had three boys, so you know, she got three boys. We ate. But I'm going to tell you something, my mama got a blessing or a breakthrough. She'll say, y'all come here. Y'all get in this kitchen right now. I'm about to give y'all a jewel. Y'all get in this kitchen right now. Much is forgiven, much is required. She said, much is given, much is required. You think God is going to let you go to the next level without no change? No change from within. No development in your mind. You think God just going to keep upgrading your life? Blessing after blessing without no testing, without no change. You got to be out your mind. Whom God calls, he qualifies. So the reality is, for where you trying to be, are you willing to change? Are you willing to accept the challenge? Are you willing to grow? Are you willing to mature? Because this will tell you a lot about your character and how serious you are about your life today and where you going forward in your future. See, y'all got to start taking you serious before life can start taking you serious. Life don't take you serious without changing you for the better because you don't take you serious. Folk treat you how you treat you. So the reality is, you got one life to live. I want you to challenge yourself to grow. Challenge yourself to mature. Some people, I had a client tell me a while back, oh, Jeff, that's just who I am. And I said, you comfortable with that? You comfortable with that? You comfortable with that behavior? I said, that's why your life the way it is. A head drop. I said, you make an excuse. If you look for an excuse, you'll find one. You'll find one. You'll find one. I said, you satisfied with who you are right now. Come on now. But you unhappy. Your relationship ain't working. Your money ain't right. Your credit score ain't good. That's just who I am. And I said, it ain't much. It ain't much. I don't even know how you satisfied with who you are in that temple of yours. I said, it's time for a change today, baby. You need to grow up. You need to mature for what you want to have out of this life. For where you want to go. For where God is going to take you. You need to grow up. You need to challenge yourself to change. To grow. To mature. Because where you want to be comes with great requirements. This is why my mother said much is given, much is required. Because where you trying to go, what you trying to be, what you trying to get, comes with loaded requirements. Some of y'all, come on, speak God. Some of y'all blessings right now that you want is requiring you to mature. Requiring you to have more self-control. Requiring you to forgive. Come on, speak God, because I'm talking to somebody. Requiring you to love. Requiring you to stop being lazy. Requiring you to stop making excuses. Oh, come on, come on. Somebody on this live has something they truly want. And God said, before I can take you to, you're going to have to change some things in you. Come on, come on. It's giving me chills all through my body, making a hair stand up all over my body, because you on this live with a great desire, but don't want to change for where you want to go. See, you got to make it make sense. Ain't no sense of desiring if you ain't willing to work to change, work to grow, work to develop, because you're going to get there undeveloped, and you ain't gonna be able to keep what you got. It ain't gonna last. You're gonna be unstable. As quick as it comes, it's gonna go. Why? Because your dreams, your aspirations, gonna find out that you wasn't ready. You wasn't well prepared. You wasn't qualified. See, folk want things instant, but you better put some respect on a process, because that full process will have it last, meaning forever, versus somebody who gets something quick. See, if you put quick in your mix, as quick as it comes, it'll go. And it lasts 5 minutes because you was in a rush. You had no patience. When the elder said patience is a virtue, it says when you tap into your virtue, you understand the essence of patience, which gives you wisdom and knowledge to put some respect on time. It was just a matter of time, baby. I've been praying. I've been fasting. I've been waiting. Oh, man. Yeah. I anticipated this. Oh, yeah. I got excited about this. I kept it on my mind. Yeah, it was just a matter of time. But I tapped into my virtue to understand the essence of patience. The development, I learned something in the process of waiting. Waiting. See, that's why God won't give you that blessing right now, because in the process, God is going to give you something that you need, that when you get there, you're going to be able to sustain the lifestyle that you want. Ain't no sense of getting there and then you can't keep it. Ain't no sense of getting there and you can't sustain what you have. There's plenty of people out here that gets a lot of things, but it don't last. This year they get it. Next year they don't have it anymore. Why? Because they wasn't prepared. See, I always say in wisdom, it's one thing to get a blessing, but it's a whole nother ball game to be able to keep it and pass it down, or be able to say 5 years, 10 years later, you still got it. See, y'all got to start making it make sense. Because folk get deceived and behooved by asking for blessings. No, when you bless me, God, give me wisdom so I can be able to keep it. Give me wisdom so I can be able to sustain it. Give me wisdom so that I can be able to bless my children with it when I'm done with it. Yeah. It's one thing to get a blessing. It's a whole nother ball game to be able to keep it. Pass it down. Have it for a long time. Some of y'all just got to grow up. You got to grow up so God can show up. Then here comes the glow up. Bam. Just like that. It came. See, y'all don't understand. Today can be one of the best days of your life if you challenge yourself to change. That phone call you've been waiting for can come today. That breakthrough you've been waiting for can come today. That thing you've been desiring, it can come today. That approval you've been seeking, it can come today. You don't know what today gonna bring. You don't know what life gonna offer when you preparing and you setting yourself up, being ready for where you trying to go. Instead of focusing on what you've been through, what you're going through, look at what your experience, where it's taking you. Some of y'all are going to some promising places by the negative challenges you're facing. It's challenging you to grow. God said, I sent it to you to develop you. I sent it to you, or I allowed it to strengthen you. Because where you're going, you're going to need a strong mind. Come on, speak that. God said, I allowed this experience to come. You didn't like it. It made you feel uncomfortable. It made you want to quit. But God said, I sent it and allowed it. So when you get there, you're going to be mentally strong now. You ain't going to quit when you face other challenges and trials and tribulations of various kinds. This one experience is going to equip you for where I'm taking you. So when you get to that high promotion, when you get to that high position, when you get to that new higher level, you're not just going to be existing. You're going to be thriving. You're going to be successful. And challenges are going to come, but it ain't going to shake you. It ain't going to break you. If anything, it's going to make you. See, I'm going to tell you something. Some of my biggest blessings came from bad situations. Some of my biggest challenges led me to some of the best days of my life, best opportunities of my life. But you got to be willing to accept the challenge and challenge yourself to change, to grow. Because these little small classes of development and experiences in life is going to equip you where God is taking you. You only got one life to live. And I advise you to walk by faith and stop aligning yourself to fear. Because fear ain't going to never get you to where you want to be. But faith will. Faith will. If you believe, you shall receive, you shall achieve. Some of y'all are some great bona fide overachievers when you get certain negative, raggedy people out your life. Some of y'all can be some great successors if you just get them negative thoughts out your mind. That's stinking thinking. Some of y'all can do some great and phenomenal things in life if you get these raggedy peep folk and emotions out of your heart, out of your spirit. Stop focusing on things in life that you can't control and things you can't change. Make it make sense. You got one life to live, and you choose with your valuable time to focus on that. With your valuable time, you chose to feel like this. At some point, you're going to have to grow up. You're going to have to mature. You're going to have to become more spiritually disciplined. If you're trying to get to where you're trying to go. If you're trying to be who you're trying to be. If you're trying to have what you're trying to have. I'm going to tell you, you're going to have to become more spiritually disciplined. More spiritual discipline. Much is given, much is required. That level you're trying to go to comes with great requirements. You can't approach something new with the old you. God said the you of you today ain't ready for where God's trying to take you tomorrow. So you got to challenge yourself to change. Challenge yourself to grow. Challenge yourself for development. Because it's one thing to get a blessing, but it's a whole nother ballgame to be able to keep it. Enjoy it. Pass it down. Be able to have it for longer than 5 to 10 years. Allow it to be service to your life. Great service to your life. You only get one life to live. But the reality is, you settle. And when you settle, you sell. And when you sell yourself short every time. Why? Because you don't have no patience. And this is why I say, when the elder said patience is a virtue, when you tap into the virtue, oh, you put more respect on the essence of patience, meaning you put more respect on your time. Learning how to wait to trust the true process. Folk want blessings, folk want opportunities instantly like grits. Oh, certain situations take a longer process. Because it's a bigger blessing. It's a greater promotion. It's a bigger upgrade. But you gotta tap into the essence of patience. And you do it by tapping into your virtue. This is how you become victorious. Victorious over the things you seek. The things you desire. With life, I always say this to y'all. Where there's very little guarantees, there's great possibilities. The two guarantees of life is you live and you die. All I care about with you in your life is what you do in the meantime, in between time. What are you doing right now? How did you wake up? How are you thinking? What are your plans? What are your goals? What are the things you desire? What are the things you know that nobody else don't know that you need to work on personally? Much is given, much is required. You can't go somewhere new with the old you. God said that ain't enough. It ain't enough. It ain't enough to sustain where you're going. So I challenge you to grow. I challenge you to change. I challenge you to develop. And this can lead to some of the best days of your life. Why? Because you qualified. You said you want to do that, you qualify for that. You said you want to go there, you qualify for that. You said you want to be promoted, you qualify for that. Why? Because you're so busy, you're so caught up with self. You're so caught up with working on you. You're so caught up on maturing that you're ready for everything God throw at you. You're ready for every opportunity that comes your way. You're ready for big blessings. It ain't going to change you, it's just going to inspire you more and inspire others to get their life together. God ain't so much concerned about them. God is worried about you. If you respond in anger 99.9% of the time, at some point you got to grow up and mature. If you want better outcomes, you need a different response. You can't keep responding with cursing, getting mad, want to fight, want to do this, that, and the third that's negative, doing an eye for an eye. If you want better outcomes, you got to change your response. God ain't trying to change them. God trying to change you. You don't like the way they move. You don't like the way they operate. You don't like what they said. Well, limit how much time you deal with them or don't deal with them at all. But I'm not so concerned about what they do. I'm more concerned about how I respond, my self-control, my development. I'm concerned about me because I got to be with me today and for the rest of my life. So I can't get caught up with the acts or the words of somebody outside of me. I'm concerned about me. I walked away from a situation. I was like, man, I feel good. I ain't even get mad. I didn't get upset. I said, boy, I know I'm growing up. I know I'm mature. That was some people will poke at you. Some people try to hit you below the belt. I said, man, that thing didn't even touch me. That thing didn't even bother me. It didn't even shake my spirit a bit. If anything, I looked at them like, man, you ain't gonna never change. You ain't gonna never amount to nothing in life. Because that's just who you are. And you ain't willing to change. You ain't willing to grow up. Attacking people with your words. It didn't bother me not a bit. I looked at her, she looked at me, and I said, well, I guess that's just the way you want to be, huh? That's why you ain't going to mouth to nothing. Because the reality is, nobody can be blessed and nobody can be happy function the way like that. Nobody. You can't be happy personally if you wake up in the morning attacking people negatively with your words. Coming with great bad intent against somebody else. You can't be happy personally. Because happy is what happy does. So be conscious of your response. Be conscious of who you entertain. You got one life to live, and when it's over, it's over. I want you to accomplish all your goals before you die. All your aspirations before you die. There are so many people in the grave right now who have a lot of unfinished dreams and aspirations and goals. Because they sit around and joked and jived, allowed themselves to be distracted, allowed themselves to be put out of position, off track. People wasted so much of their time. The grave is full of people who have unfinished dreams and goals. Don't let that be you. Don't let that be you. Because you acting a fool or don't have no discipline or self-control. Let me tell you something. Every situation does not warrant you to get mad. Every situation does not warrant you to get upset. Just because somebody says something I don't like don't mean I got to get in my feelings or jump to my heart instantly. At some point, you got to grow up. For where you want to be, for where God is taking you, you're going to have to change something in you. My mother said it best, much is given, much is required. Baby, you want to go there? Okay, that's going to come with some requirements. Baby, you want that? Okay, that's going to come with some requirements. Oh, baby, you want to go to that level? Oh, that's going to come with some requirements. Much is given, much is required. Y'all think y'all just going to get to somewhere and be able to sustain your life there without no requirements, without no change, without no new developments in you? You want to go somewhere new, but don't want to put nothing new in you to actually keep you where you're going. Make it make sense. Wisdom says anything new going to require something new out of you. Come on, speak, God. Anything new. Wisdom says anything new going to require something new out of you. I'm the king of analogies. Let's just say what? Relationships. You in a new relationship. So you can't come in a new relationship with your ex vibes, your past experiences, that past mentality. You're going to ruin your relationship before it even begins. Because you're in something new, trying to function with the old you. This is why folk gotta heal. That's why folk gotta develop. That's why folk need therapy. Folk need counseling. Because you over here walking in with new relationships and approaching new opportunities with baggage, attitude, issues that you picked up from somebody else, and now you're putting it on the new person. That ain't right. That ain't fair. You come in with your insecurities. Seek help first. Function in your singlehood for proper development so you don't do the same damage. See, I'm going to tell you something about healing. If you don't seek healing, the healing you need, you're going to become the very person who hurt you. This is why they say hurt people, because if you hurt and you don't seek to heal, you're going to be cloned, becoming the very person who wronged you, and you will do that to the new person you deal with. Yeah. Hurt people. The opposite of hurt is healing, baby. So if you don't seek healing after you've experienced hurt or pain, you're going to become the very person who wronged you. Yeah. The very individual who betrayed you. The very individual who broke your heart. You need to seek healing so you don't cross-contaminate. You went from this relationship, got hurt, didn't seek healing, then go over here and jump into a new relationship, cross-contaminating. You went over there, you picked up the same, you took the same vibes you got from your bad relationship and took it into a potentially good relationship and ruined it before it started. This is why you need healing, baby. Hurt people. And if you don't seek healing, you're going to become cloned spiritually. Cross-contaminating that new person, that new opportunity that could have bettered your life. Some of y'all ain't ready for love but want love. God said, if your desire is going to be high, your productivity need to be matching it. Because you can't have high desires with poor productivity. You can't have great wants but ain't willing to change. Much is given, much is required. My mama said that thing. She meant that thing. She would cook. She'd be cooking in that kitchen and something would hit her. Wisdom would hit her. The Holy Spirit hit her in some type of way. And she said, y'all get in here. Let me tell y'all something. Much is given, much is required. Sons, y'all can be and have whatever you want to have in this life. But just know, whatever it is, it's going to come with some requirements. And you got to, if you really truly want it, you're going to change for it. You're going to develop for it. You're going to do what you got to do to get it the right way. Much is given, much is required. God said you got to grow up. You need to mature. You need to challenge yourself to change for the betterment, for the very things you desire out of this life. God said some of these desires come with great requirements, and it will not come into your life until you change, until you meet the requirements of what you desire. Come on, speak. I'm talking to somebody right now because you want it bad. But if you want it truly bad enough, you'll change for what that thing is requiring, what that relationship requiring, what that car is requiring, what that house is requiring, what that promotion is requiring. I'm going to tell you, you can have the desires all you want, but you got to meet the requirements because much is given, much is required. And whom God calls, he qualifies. Come on now. Those who love and support me, like and share. Like and share. Send us to somebody who need to get their life together, who needs some morning inspiration. It's Hot Topic Thursday. Do you really want it? Because if you really want it, you'll change for it. You'll develop for it. Because ain't no sense of getting a blessing, and as quick as the blessing comes, it goes. Why? Because you weren't ready. You just wanted it so bad and so fast and so instant that you didn't even trust the process of development to actually get the best blessing, but also be able to keep and enjoy it. Come on, speak, God. Speak, God. It's you. You're the issue. You just need to grow up and mature. So those of you who love and support me, like and share, I appreciate it. It would have been on me without you. If I inspire you some type of way, my Venmo, my Cash App is pinned up. It's in the title. But I'm going to tell you something with this life. You better understand, much is given and much is required. Because some of y'all on this live with some great wants. And God said, I ain't giving it to you until you change. I ain't giving it to you until you grow up. I ain't giving it to you until you develop. I ain't giving it to you until you change your response to every negative thing you hear. You can hear the immaturity in certain people by how they respond to certain situations. I don't care. Your age don't mean nothing. God is no respect of any person, so neither will I. You can say you grown all you want to. You can look grown. You can act like you grown. You can dress grown. But some of y'all walk around here with the spirit of a 15-year-old, a mind of a 15-year-old, and you well of age. God said, when you gonna grow up? You said you want it. You said you wanted to have it. Well, act like it. Grow up. Mature. Challenge yourself to change. Because what you desire will not come until you change. You gotta want this as bad as you want to breathe. Because you want things to get better. But you don't want to do better from the inside. God said, how is that you want this? But you don't want to change who you are. Wisdom says anything new gonna require something new out of you. Anything new. Jump that too? Yeah, anything new. Anything new gonna require something new out of you. Whether it's a new relationship, a new job, anything new is gonna require something new out of you. So if you ain't willing to change, baby, you don't really want it. You can draw near with your mouth, but your heart is far apart. Because one who truly desires is willing to change. You said you want your marriage to work out. You say you want your relationship to last. Well, show it. Prove it. By growing up. Maturing. Changing your response. Showing up every day, because a relationship is work. You said you want that promotion. Prove it. Work on you. Self-development. Having spiritual discipline. See, you got to be willing to change. Otherwise, you ain't ready. And Lord knows you ain't qualified. Because you thought you can approach something new with the old you. I always say at the end of my life, you know my life for me. You know my life for me. And I don't put no gun in your head to come over here. But I hope by you coming over here, I've inspired you in some type of way to get your life together. I want you to do something about yourself. I want you to do something about your life. You only get one of these, and when it's over, it's over. I want you to, what my mother always say to us, man, we had to look it up. Because for a long time, we was like, man, what is this woman talking about? I'm like, mama crazy. Excuse me. I'm like, mama crazy. Like, she said, you need some gumption. You need some gumption about yourself. It's like, gumption, mama? What is she talking about? Man, if I some get some gumption about yourself. Some get up and go. A drive. Some dignity. Take some initiative about your life, yourself. Get your act together. Some of y'all that came into 2022 with a 2021 mind frame, come on, speak God. Lord knows you telling, I'm telling the truth. You that came into 2022 with a 2021 mind frame, and you wonder why your life ain't jumped off as the year already started. It's you. You're your worst enemy. You need to get some gumption about yourself. Some dignity. Find some pride about you. Make you a priority. Get your act together. Love yourself more. Exercise. Drink some water. Get more rest. Create plans, preparation, and action. Learn how to manifest. Meet some new people. Build some new bridges. Your network is your net worth. It's time for a change. You want better? Well, you need to attest to it by your productivity, by your actions. God said, I'm from the show me state. Show me. If you want it, show me then. Because your actions attest to the opposite of what you truly desire. Come on, speak, God. I'm talking to somebody right now. It's giving me chills all over my body. Because your action don't match up or line up with what you desire. You said you want that. No, you don't. Look at how you operate. Look at how you talk. Look at how you function. Look at how you move. Look at how you respond. You childish. You immature. You won't grow up. And for because you won't grow up, your things that you desire will never come to pass, will never come to fruition because you won't change. God said, I ain't worried about them. We already know they ain't no good. I ain't worried about what they said. We already know what they said was negative. But God is more concerned about your response, your reaction to what you're experiencing. God ain't trying to change them. God trying to change you. God ain't caring about them. God is more worried about you. It's always been about you. What are you willing to do for what you want out of this life? What are you willing to change? When are you going to grow up? Where is your maturity? Because ain't no sense of getting there and can't stay there. Ain't no sense of getting there, and as quick as you got there, you want to get out because you find out you wasn't ready or qualified. See, you gotta get up. You gotta grow up. You just gonna have to grow up, baby. I don't care. Your age don't mean nothing to me. I got clients older than me. I got clients younger than me. Your age don't mean nothing. You gotta get yourself together. You gotta get yourself together before you get up out of here, because, baby, you're gonna die. You coming up out of here one way or another. But I don't want you to look over your life and say, well, man, I could have did this. I could have did that. I could have did this better. No, how about do it now? Folk inbox me all the time. Jeff, when should I write a book? When should I start a business? When should I leave my job or seek a new position? Jeff, when should I do this? When should I start working out, working on my body? Jeff, I was thinking about this idea. When should I do this? Now. Now. Now, 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 now. Why are you talking as if you got guarantees? As if you guaranteed to live the next hour? Who you fooling? The biggest lie is the one you tell yourself, and I'm going to tell you, it's very disrespectful to universal law, principles, and values, not understanding life. Now. Now would be a great time to start. Jeff, when? Jeff, when? Jeff, when? Now. Now. You can start now. Because you're talking as if you got time. Ask the people in the grave. Ask the people that's in jail. You got time though. Now would be a great time to start. Why are you talking as if you got all your life to do what you want to do? You don't. Because you can go at any moment. So why are you procrastinating? Come out for under the spirit of procrastination. Get to it right now. While you can. While you able. Because if you can't start it now, then you ain't serious about it. You don't really truly want it. You just do a lot of talking, but ain't a lot of doing. Like I posted yesterday, beware of people who got boss talk, but don't got that boss walk. You better go sit down somewhere playing with me. Because you're going to get off this live pin shoulder bow leg. You got to go get a new pedicure fooling around with me. The truth hurts. But I'd rather you be hurt for a moment than to be damaged for a lifetime, because the truth will set you free. And you don't know where that freedom going to take you. That freedom can take you to joy. That freedom can take you to love. That freedom can take you to peace. That freedom can secure your life today and your life going forward. It can even grant you financial stability. The truth will set you free. God said, you don't know what I put in that freedom, but you got to live in your truth. You got to live in your truth. You don't know what God put in that freedom. But as long as you stay shackled mentally, as long as you stay in prison spiritually, you keep yourself from some of the greatest opportunities and moments life had to offer for you. There are a lot of unfulfilled goals and dreams and aspirations in that grave. Coulda, woulda, shoulda. If I had another chance, I woulda. Don't be like them. Be better. So I challenge you to change. Change, grow up, mature, because this is your life. And can't nobody live it for you, and can't nobody want more for you than you want for yourself. I would say at the end of my life, peace and love. A man functions off peace, a woman functions off love. Don't play with it. Better stay with it. Better keep put some respect on men and women's drives. Because if you are a drive killer, don't be mad when somebody kill your drive. Don't get mad when somebody start attacking you. That's the seeds you sow. That's your karma. Anything that's God sent or God given, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away if you don't appreciate. See, y'all don't put respect on your life. See, when folk do you wrong, you don't check them as quick as they tried to move wrong with you. See, but God is different. When you move a certain type of way, the Lord giveth and the Lord sure enough will take it away. I'm going to tell you, I done seen it when I was young. I done seen it when I was older. Oh, God make you put respect on his name. It's for the name's sake. Much is given, much is required. Anything God sent, God given that goes unappreciated, the Lord giveth, and the Lord sure enough will take it away. And folk wonder why. Folk, the enemy tries to say, oh, you too hard, you too strong, you too stern. Oh, you're mean. No, baby, I mean well, and I take my life serious. Don't get mad at me because you love wasting your time. Don't get mad because you won't grow up immature. Don't get mad because you were wasting your life, ruining your life with your dumb choices and your dumb decisions. No. My family let you know right now. Oh, folks start cutting up, doing wrong. I ain't got to say bye to y'all niggas. I'm getting my karma leave. I'll call and text whoever I care for or care to know where I'm at, and I'm going to keep it moving. You know Jeff ain't dealing with that. You know Jeff ain't entertaining that. You know Jeff ain't arguing with you. You know Jeff ain't about to get mad and upset, ruin his day, put a whole lot of pressure on his body all because of your ignorant behind. No, oh, that's who we are? All right, then, okay. Hey, well, I guess you're asking me to leave. I'm out. See, you ain't got to stay. Y'all love staying in the kitchen while it's hot. Y'all love entertaining bad souls, dark souls, oh, people with bad energy. No, I don't have to do that. I didn't wake up like that. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning. No, I don't have to entertain that. I done planned, I done prepared. I done spoke over my day. I done told myself I done had a great day. I expect it. I don't hope. I don't say if. I expect it. So what are you expecting? What have you planned? What have you prepared? What action are you going to take today so you can live your best life today and your life going forward? If you don't respect, if you take a man peace, he gonna seek peace in some other person, place, or thing. If you play with a woman's love, she is gonna find love in some other person, place, or thing, because men get tired and women get fed up. Hello. See, women love easy and men stay too long. Hot topic Thursday. Women love too easy and men stay too long. Yeah. But as you grow up and mature, you make better choices. You make better investments with your heart, your mind, your soul, and your time. Because these things have great value. You got to put some respect on my name. And you better put some respect on your name as well. And stop allowing and accepting people to move and operate a certain type of way that is so dishonorable, so distasteful, so damaging, so distracting to your life and what you're trying to do and where you're trying to go. Come on now. You got one life to live. Come on. Those who love and support me, like and share. And if I inspire you some type of way, my Venmo, my Cash App is in the title, is pinned up. But you got one. You get one of these. It's called life. See life as an opportunity. That's the best gift you could have got from today. Open it up. Enjoy it. Somebody didn't get this opportunity. Somebody fought trying to get in today, and look at you. Got your gift and ain't opened it up yet. The present. You got the gift of life and look how you woke up with your raggedy spirit having itself. God can't bless you for 5 minutes without complaining, without quitting, without giving up, without making excuses. Look at you. Change. Grow up. Go up under the spirit of gratitude. Be thankful. There's plenty of people in jail, homeless, because it's cold outside. People in the grave that will switch places with you. But look how you treat your blessing. Ain't even open up your gift yet to say, you know what? I thank God to be alive. I thank God to have activity in my bones. I thank God for having a right mind, in my right mind. Thank God for my health and my strength. But here you is waking up complaining. Today can be one of the best days of your life if you renew your mind. Today is new. Yesterday is old. But like I said, anything new gonna require something new out of you. What are you bringing to the table of your life that is new? Because if you're not prepared to go to, God ain't going to push you through because you ain't qualified. You ain't ready. You ain't serious. So I love y'all, man. And I pray that you make better choices because you only get one of these. And you can go at any moment. Could be today, could be tomorrow, could be 10 years, 20 years from now. But I can tell you, some of the decisions you can make can determine if you see the next 30 years. I need you to be conscious. I need you to be willing and be ready. Challenge yourself to change. Because I'm going to tell you something. Life can change just like this. At one moment you was down, but now you at the highest state you've ever been. You have more money you've ever had. You felt more good than you've ever felt. You, oh man, you in a situation you ain't never experienced. Oh man, life can be so rich if you can just renew your mind. You are God's design. I need you to flex your power. I need you to love yourself more. I need you to bet on you. I am Jay Pitts Presents. I am your life coach, and class is dismissed. Hot Topic Thursday, baby. Let's go. Let's go. Saha, take us home, baby. Yeah, one life to live, baby. You just get one. Take advantage of this time, baby. You alive. That's all that matters. I don't care about what you've been through, what you're going through. You alive.
Yeah.
You alive.
Yeah. I'm just a young man from Stone Mountain, Georgia. Failed every class. I flunked out before the 11th grade. They told me I had a disorder. Read every song Hebrew sound like a poem out the Torah. So I learned to break a zone down the quarters. Had to crush on Crystal like Urkel had on Laura. I told her God is my attorney. I never go to court without my lawyer. So hit me up when you... I guess my decorum didn't match my aura. Shit, I'm just a bachelor.
I'm free, baby.
Running back and forth.
I'm free.
With different women.
Are you free?
I had my fair share. If I retire, I'm still a Hall of Famer like Gail Sayers. Black bottle nigga, Prince of Bel Air. I need more than a bitch who sell hair. I'm talking healthcare. Strip clubs is the new welfare. Brothers pussy ain't. So it's cheaper to keep up than run the street with your people. Fold deep in the regal, smoking weed with an eagle. All we see is illegal. Get a key from amigos, make sure you keep it cerebral. Lay underneath the cathedral, smoke a leaf of Khalifa before I meet with the Reaper. I'ma kidnap a bird right after she let me free, cause she fell asleep in the fetal. The next morning I let her.
Gotta be free. You gotta be free. Stop being shackled mentally. Stop being so shackled mentally. When you gonna become free? Living for other people and yet have not yet lived for yourself. Make it make sense.
Yeah. Feel like I'm being enslaved. Married to a bitch, it's hard being engaged. You spent your all on your gift, but you work minimum wage. And she turned right back around and spit in your face. She tell you you ain't good enough. She tell you you ain't hood enough. She talking about who she should've fucked with. And now you tired of putting up with her shit. So you decided to leave, go fuck with them other niggas. Them niggas not in my league. Less than a year later, I'm as hot as Belize. I'm no detective, but now she copping the plea. She wanna know if I'm good and how was my week. You don't need to ask unless you chopping the tree. It don't mean you smart cause you got a college degree. Really what I'm trying to say, I'm tired of putting music out for. Love don't cost a thing. Try saying that to the girl you bought a ring. Curse a bitch out over the phone like Charlie Sheen. With collard greens in the kitchen with Paula Deen. Cause these rollies that we got aren't cheap. The oyster with the leather band costs three. And pretty girls want a nigga who got cheese. Shout it, I thought the best things in life were.
Caught up with that situation no more. Nah, free. free. Get the worry off your shoulders. Get the weight of the world off your life. And just simply live. Enjoy. Accept things for what it is. Change. Grow up. Mature. Develop.
Free is the meal that a lady gets on the first day. Free as a bird that just left the nest for the first day. Free as the inmate who got out on parole from prison. Free as the air we breathe, it could be the last breath given. Free as the extra .5 that my nigga gave me for shopping with him for the last 3 years. Free as the Olive Garden breadsticks you take home and put in your fridge. Free as the neighborhood thot that gave every nigga the pussy. Free as the Chinese restaurant fortune cookies. Free as the peppermint butterscotch and dum-dums you get at the bank. Free as the bootlegger that downloaded my album illegally. Thanks.
Yes, sir.
We are orphans and fatherless. Our mothers are as widows. Lamentations 5:3.
I am Jay Piss Presents. I am your life coach and class is dismissed. Time is of the essence and it starts what? Right now. Make a decision. I need you to make some decisions today that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say thank you. I said, I need you to make some serious decisions today, conscious decisions today that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say thank you. Oftentimes when my mind get quiet and my heart gets settled and I got peace in my soul, I look back at the younger Jeff and say, thank you, boy. Thank you for growing up. Thank you for listening to some of the, taking in the wisdom that your mama gave you. Thank you for taking some of the experiences and applying it. See, some of y'all, your application is so weak because God has given you opportunities to grow, but it ain't showing because you didn't apply. You didn't apply what you need to excel, to go to the next level. So it's you. You your worst enemy. I'm still thinking that young Jeff for some of the decisions he made because that's the reason why I'm in a certain position that I'm in today. And going to keep making other decisions for what's best for my life going forward. So I need you to once more make a decision that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say thank you. I am Jay Piss Presents. I am your life coach and class is dismissed. Let's go, baby. Hot Topic Thursday.